It is time for UPM's second quarter 2020 results. UPM CFO Tapio Korpeinen is here to answer some questions. How would you describe UPM's second quarter results?
In the second quarter, UPM's sales decreased by about 20% compared to the second quarter one year ago. This is primarily due to lower graphic paper volumes and lower pulp prices. Our comparable EBIT was 203 million euros, which is equal to 9.8% EBIT margin. One can say that UPM Raflatac and Specialty Papers had an excellent quarter, whereas Communication Papers reported for the first time in 5 years a negative EBIT at minus 10 million euros. Graphic paper demand in the quarter in Europe was down by 32%. That impacted our volumes and also the result of Communication Papers, despite measures to contain both fixed and variable costs. Biorefining had an operationally very strong quarter in pulp. Our deliveries were very strong to our customers, as we had postponed maintenance shutdowns from the quarter to the fourth quarter of this year. Therefore, pulp mills were running at full capacity. However, pulp prices remained at a low level, which impacted the bottom line. UPM Energy was reporting a solid result despite lower electricity prices, taking advantage of volatility in the power markets. Maybe finally, one can say that our financial standing is very strong. During the quarter, we paid a dividend of 693 million euros. After that, our net debt in the end of the quarter is 301 million euros, which is down from the same point in time in the end of the second quarter last year. Liquidity for UPM as a whole at the end of the quarter was 2 billion euros.
We have stated that the COVID-19 lockdowns had a major impact during the second quarter. Can you tell more about that? How did they affect our operations?
Yes, the second quarter was the quarter where the direct impact of the COVID-related lockdowns was significantly affecting UPM businesses. Demand for graphic paper suffered the most as offices, schools were closed, many businesses were closed, or activity was restricted. As mentioned, demand in Europe was down by 32%. At the same time, demand was strong for UPM Raflatac and Specialty Papers as e-commerce grew strongly. Demand for food, others, this sort of consumer daily staple products developed favorably. As an example, demand for self-adhesive labels in Europe grew by 10% compared to last year. At the same time, one can say also that we were able to protect the safety of our employees. We were able to also, let's say, ensure the continuity of our business. A few UPM employees have been infected by the virus, and we have not had any significant disturbances in serving our customers, so there we succeeded well. Also, the Uruguay project and our biochemical project in Germany are proceeding according to the overall plan, so there we have been able to also continue as planned and ensure the progress on those projects.
Looking forward, how do you see the outlook for the rest of the year?
Uncertainty remains high due to COVID-19 and also kind of the repercussions one can expect from that for the general economy in the different regions of the world. Some of the direct impacts that we talked about from these lockdowns both negative and positive are likely to moderate now as the lockdowns are being lifted, and one can see recovery in both business and sort of consumer activity. We have clearly early signs of that recovery taking place, but we do not know exactly the rate of recovery, how it will happen during the coming quarters. Furthermore, one can say that UPM businesses obviously are dependent on the sort of general economic environment in the different markets and regions of the world where we operate, and also there uncertainty remains how that will develop during the coming quarters. But in these conditions, we will take care of our competitiveness and our profitability. Last week, we announced the closure of UPM Chapelle in France. This week, we have concluded the employee consultations to close the Jyväskylä plywood mill. So we continue to improve our efficiency, both in terms of variable cost and fixed cost. And finally, one can say that we focus on delivering on our transformative growth projects. As mentioned, the Uruguay pulp mill project and our biochemical project in Germany are well on track.
Thank you for this interview.
Thank you.